the efficacy for these vaccines are quite impressive. I think technically Pfizer's vaccine is clocking in at 95% efficacy. Moderna's is 94.1%. That's probably not really any different from a statistical standpoint, but that is amazingly high. When you think about comparing it to other vaccines, for instance, right? The flu shot, for instance. The flu shot typically has an efficacy rate that's closer to 50%, all right? Now, keep in mind, though, that the flu shot, even though it may have an efficacy that's much lower, it does a lot of work towards protecting people not just from infection, but from the complications of the flu. Whereas these vaccines seem to be very, very high in efficacy, not just at preventing infection, but possibly, we hope, certainly preventing a lot of disease too. Based on the clinical trials, there is no reason to believe that one is necessarily better than the other in terms of efficacy or side effects or tolerability. Right now, as best we can tell, they are totally equivalent. Federal guidelines, state guidelines wanted to focus on those patients who were in skilled nursing facilities, of course, and healthcare workers. As more vaccine becomes available, we're seeing that the goal is to try to start spreading out to patients, particularly those who are gonna be at high risk. So even if they're not in a skilled nursing facility, if they're older, 75 and older, then those are populations that we're gonna wanna focus on first.